Go to the Tools panel in Affinity Photo and select a shape. Obviously I've created a rectangle here. Also, you can go to the Pen tool and create a line. Now, once you've done that, what you can do, you can apply dash styles to these. What you can do, just go over here to the fill. I'm just got a fill there of nothing. Stroke color black, you of course can vary that. And also over here, the stroke width, etc. And now the key one there is the third tab. So that third tab, you've got dash settings. Now I'm just gonna use this one, the rectangle. So with the rectangle, it's a variety of different settings. You can go for cap, so you can just run through those. You see, now when I click that one, the first one, you can see a nice rounded design there. You can also click that one. You can hover over there, the butt cap as it's called, and well, square cap. And you can see a variety of different designs there. You can also vary the join, sometimes useful. You can see that one, it does change it. Now that generally doesn't have much effect. You can use it for some effects, some of those. Also, you've got alignment, so you can put that in or you can put it out. Now, of course, if you've got a fill, so if you go for a fill there and then you go for there and go to the alignment and go for inner, then you suddenly find you haven't got anything at all. So that's why I'm just going to keep it swatches with nothing there. But you can vary this. Obviously, you can vary the size. You can see then as you do that, you get very small there. But if you make it a bit bigger so you can actually see it on the screen. You've also got other options. Of course, you've got arrows here, so you can put an arrow in it if you want. But the key thing is dashes, that's down here. And now I'm going to start with, say, 0 and 0. Actually, it's not 0. The there, 0.05. Anyway, whatever that reason is why it's not 0 and 0, but it's obviously there. Now, let's go through it. Now, it does depend on the settings up here. So if you go for this one, the butt cap, so you can see now you've got butt cap there and you've got 1 and 0.0. Well, maybe that's that gap there. So again, you just go there and you can vary it. So maybe make it 0.5. You can see 0.5, you get a slight unusual there. And you can run through there. And you can see as you do that, you can vary it. And of course you can vary these settings as well, but you can go also to this cap. So you can go there. Now, personally, I always prefer to go just for this option, which is the center option. So you can see it like that. And you can move that. And as you move that, you'll notice those move around, they realign. And that's why this is useful, the phase. So you might want to go down here to the phase and just go up and down, use the up and down arrow keys. And as you do that, you'll see it move around. You go minus or positive as well. So you can go up and down just so you can just align it to a position that you're happy with. Because sometimes when you do one of these, say go here for dash, say 13 or maybe go for 12. So you can make obviously a lot larger gaps, because that's what it is, big gap there between those. So you can vary that to make that 0.2. So make it a lot smaller. You can see what happens. Again, you can go up here to the butt cap, and that's obviously a lot tinier. And you can vary it. So 0.1, let's just go for 1 now. So you can see 1 and maybe 1 and 2. So you can see that, and that's got 1 there. You can see there's 2 there in the gap, and then that's 1, and then 2 there, and 1 there. So you can change it in numerous ways. Well, you can also go maybe for 3. So you can create a variety of different designs. Maybe go for 4. And just keep changing it. Also, you can test it as well further by just changing these. So maybe go for 3. And I must admit, after a while, when you get stuck putting 7, 2, 3, the actual end results are never particularly, for me anyway, particularly obvious. So I just put those in and you might find you don't get anything that's good. And then suddenly you hit on something, you think, ooh, and you can just change it. So you can just run through it and make it 4 or go the other way and just change the settings. So experiment with 7, 2, 3 and 1. But again, it does depend on obviously the other ones as well. So you just change those. Again, alignment, you can get a variety of different designs from that. You can also again do exactly the same here. So you've got 30 points there. Obviously I can vary the width there. Just change that. And also I can again go through this and you can see as you do that, you get see a bigger gap there. If I reduce it down, so go all the way down there, 3, 2, and you can see now the end result. Again, 0.2, you get very, well, you can hardly see it. So 3 there. And also you can set, say the dashes to 5. Put that there, unless you make a mistake, like I've just put a tab in there by accident. Also put three there, and you can see a variety of different designs from that. Now I've got over here styles. And what you can do with this selected, the styles panel, that's view menu, studio and styles. You've got the option here to add style from list, from selection. So add style from there, and it will add that to that. And go to this one, and again, I can do exactly the same. So add style from selection, and it will add, it calls style 27, 28, etc. But you can also run through these. So you can see that one, start, and again, you click up there, you can see now one and one. You can see different options there. Again, you run through those, and you can see a variety of different, these ones are sort of cut out because of the order. So if you change the order here, you've got order set in here, so you can put that different order. You can see that goes, all depends on the there, whether it's inside or out. Again, you can see the order does change it by doing that. And you can also run through the styles again, more and more. Now, what you can also do is change the color. So you don't, the color is stored with the style as well as all these various settings here. So that's a variety of different designs there. And you can, and of course you can add other things as well. So you don't have to have just that. You can see, as I run through the styles, there's a whole load of different varieties. There's like dots there. So you've got a nice dot design there. And again, let's expand that out. You've got 50 there between the gap. So maybe, you know, turn around and say two instead. So you can see now you've got two or maybe three. And again, just if you want to, just up and down. Well, if it lets you, sometimes it's weird. Sometimes the up and down arrow just did not want to respond. So you can vary it. And you've got all the things saved over here that you can run through. However, one thing you've got to remember, one that sometimes when you do some of these things, suddenly you find that you're just not getting anything. And that's why I like the styles over here. Because sometimes if I've got myself into a situation where I'm suddenly thinking, why isn't something appearing? Why isn't something? You can always get out of it by quickly clicking over here. If you've got a style that works, you should be able to get out of the situation over here. You might have found thinking, why doesn't that work now? But you can also find over here, if you click this one, go to pressure. You set the pressure, and I've done this in a previous video. Please check that video out. It's about the call out tool. Made a slight mistake. Someone pointed it out to me. You cannot use pressure with the dashes. So if you go like that and you can see what happens, it varies the width there. Now I go to the dashes, got dash settings there, totally ignores. But again, quickly get out of it just by going over here, clicking there. And again, you're back again to using this and varying this value. And again, depending on the thing, select that one and you can select those and you can run through those very quickly as well. Obviously you can see there, it's got a fill color. Obviously the line hasn't got a fill. Hope you found this of interest. Please check out the end screen video. I say it's all about the call out, the showing thing. And this is why I did this video, because I wanted to go through and show about the pressure feature as well as just going through the dash style as well. Thank you much.